We drove from Reykjavik through the interior. It's very barren, it's pure volcanic landscape, volcanic sands, extinct volcanoes, lava flows, this sort of thing. The trip to Iceland was a sort of collaborative effort between Birkbeck College, University of London, and University College London, and the Leeds University as well. So the main reason why we were going to this particular field site was because you do have an enormous variation in terms of environments where microbes like to live. And you have things like bubbling pools of mud, we have fumaroles, geothermally heated ground, as well as really big meltwater lakes. As you walk down to the field site, you see this big lake within the ice, and it has a sort of beach along the edge of it. So whenever you got a bit chilly, you just had to lie down on this beach for a bit. It literally was about 90 odd degrees, just a few sort of inches below the surface. So it's kind of like sitting in a heated chair in a car. it warms you up really nicely. We went there to sample things like sediments, waters, really thick biomass. You see them everywhere, and it's a very microbial dominated environment. So they kind of grow up to macroscopic levels, and you get these big, thick, kind of gross gelatinous biomass growing everywhere. There's not really any other type of life. So it's a really strange environment, it's very otherworldly. And we were going there essentially for that reason, the fact that it's a really good analog environment for extraterrestrial environments in the past. On Mars, you have evidence of volcano-ice interaction, sort of geomorphological evidence, the fact that cryospheric and volcanic processes are widespread throughout Martian history. It means that these sorts of environments are very likely to have existed on Mars in the past. When we send missions to places like Mars, obviously we're only looking at the rocks from those environments which existed maybe 2 billion, 3 billion years ago. So any significant part of that life is long since gone. Nothing is living there anymore, but you have chemical signs in the rocks which you have to know what to look for, which is then what's going to tell you what sort of life might have been living there in the past. And it's these sorts of biosignatures that rovers, such as the ExoMars rover, which is a European Space Agency mission to Mars, and that has the prime goal of looking for evidence of life in the rock record. So knowing what instruments to send, what chemicals to look for, is sort of integral to this broader understanding of life on other planets other than Earth. Iceland is a very volcanically active country, so you wouldn't necessarily think that you get glaciers on top of them. However, the fact that you have volcanism means you have very elevated topography, which then the higher altitude combined with the high latitude then means you get glaciers. And Vatnajökull, which is the glacier that we went on, that's the biggest glacier in Europe, and I think it has something like 7 active volcanic centres underneath it at the moment. One of which erupted shortly before we were supposed to go on our trip, Grímsvötn volcano. But we did actually still manage to go out there 2 weeks later. Just because it's very remote to the place that we're trying to get to, we have to hire specialised vehicles, specialised guides to get us up there. So we could only afford to have 8 days at this particular site. However, those 8 days are not particularly comfortable living. You know, it's 6 people living basically in a shed. You have no running water, very little heating, sort of no sanitary conditions whatsoever. So it's 8 days is probably, you know, enough before you all start going a bit mad. Going to some of these places where very few people have been able to go is really quite special, particularly going to the Grímsvötn caldera crater in the ice. That was very cool. I mean, it's 2 weeks old and very few people have gone up to see it. And you're standing on the edge of this crater thinking, you know, wow, this erupted literally 2 weeks ago. And we're here like standing right on the edge of it. And that's really awesome.